أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين My dear respected brothers and honorable elders, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum salam.
I would like to start off by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us all the opportunity to get together on this very blessed day. Today, I'll be talking about a quality which is vital and important for a Muslim. A quality which all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had. A quality which the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have. It is also an attribute which every Muslim in this universe should also possess. It is such a quality that once a Muslim has perfected it, it stops him from falling into wrong and doing sins which anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That quality is taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the Quran as a guidance for mankind. And it is a guidance specifically for those who have taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarified it in many different verses throughout the Quran. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلِفْ لَمْ مِيمْ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ أَلِفْ لَمْ مِيمْ This is the book in which there is no doubt, a guidance unto those who have taqwa. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون Those who believe in the unseen and establish salah and spend that which we have bestowed upon them. In these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly tells us why He sent down the Quran to us and that He sent it down to us as a guidance. Taqwa is such an attribute that the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all possess it, and we know this from the following verse. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ Unquestionably, indeed, the allies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be no fear for them, nor will they grieve. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ Those who believe and were God-fearing. And in these verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically highlighted two qualities which the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had. And these are, number one, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Those who have iman. Number two, وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ And they have taqwa. So what is iman? Who does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala classify as a mu'min? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us who these people are and what their qualities are. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Indeed, the believers are only those who, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned, their hearts become fearful. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا And when his verses are recited to them, the iman becomes stronger. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ And upon their Lord they rely. These are the qualities of a mu'min. And the second quality which is required to become a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taqwa. It says in the Quran, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ Those who believe in the unseen. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ And establish salah. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ And establish salah from that which we have bestowed upon him. These qualities that I have mentioned to you about taqwa and iman are the qualities that are needed to attain guidance from the Quran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all of his companions were all God-fearing, despite the fact that Jannah was promised to them in advance. And you and me have been promised nothing. Yet we claim that we love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and we will die for him. But we do not follow his teaching and do not listen to what he has preached. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to learn, study and implement the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our daily lives. Ameen. Wa akhru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.